call it a virus, a browser hijack, malware, adware, whatever you call it, you don't want one on your computer. But if you do get one, there's a great tool to help you get rid of it. Malwarebytes is probably the one tool you need to install in addition to your antivirus software. Quite simply, it's brilliant. Google Malwarebytes and go to their home page. You'll have the option to buy it or to install a free version. Start by downloading the free version and click Open. You'll need to agree the license and then follow the installation steps. I let it choose where to install, but I don't want the free trial yet, so I uncheck that checkbox. You'll then see that there's a new icon on your desktop and the control panel for Malwarebytes will open. The first thing that it does is to update its threat database. And this can take a few minutes if it's a new installation. But once that's done, click on the rather obvious Scan Now button to start your first scan. Depending on the size of your computer and the number of files you have, it can take quite a while to scan. And although it will scan in the background, it'll slow you down, so choose a time when you don't need the machine for anything else. This particular scan took about 8 minutes to complete. Malwarebytes works in two ways. Firstly, it scans every file on your computer and compares it against a list of malware signatures that it downloads to its database. Because new malware is being released into the wild all the time, it's a major job keeping up with it, and you need to make sure that your antivirus and malware databases are regularly updated. But not all malware shows up on a database, so Malwarebytes also checks the behavior of suspicious files. It's called heuristic analysis. If they appear to do something suspicious, like trying to change your browser settings, Malwarebytes flags them up. Heuristics can throw up false positives, but you can upload the file to virustotal.com to check it. Once Malwarebytes has completed its scan, it will flag any suspicious files. And here's the results of my scan. Thankfully, there's no malware on there, but there are a lot of PUPs, or potentially unwanted programs. Malwarebytes has already put them in quarantine, so I can either restore them or delete them. Well, I'm going to get rid of all of them, so I click Delete All. Am I sure? I sure am sure. And they're gone. Now, here's what the scan could look like if malware had been detected. An initial scan is essential, but it's a good idea to scan your computer at least once a month. Low-grade infections can really slow things down, and you may not realize you're hosting malware that your computer will spread to other people's machines, say every time you send an email. Having tried out the free program, you can choose to upgrade to premium. It's not too expensive, and it is a great tool. But there's another option if you don't want the bother of installing and running Malwarebytes yourself. If you have an account with eTop technology, we automatically run this software across all of our networks, so you don't have to bother with it. And if you do get an infection that you can't delete, or you're suspicious about the behavior of your computer, then eTop technology will sort it for you. eTop technology, we're here to help. If you like these videos, please visit our channel for more helpful how-tos and subscribe.